any act of goodness in a time of where there was a lot of evil, any act of goodness, that has to be acknowledged and that has to be told. You have to recognize goodness for what it is. That is also in the Jewish tradition, an obligation. An act of goodness has to be told.
Yad Vashem in Jerusalem is Israel's central Holocaust memorial. Since 1963, it has sought to identify people who helped or saved Jews faced with persecution by Nazi Germany and its henchmen. Eberhard Helmrich and Donata Hart met in Berlin in the late 1920s. Donata, the child of a liberal, educated Greek-German family, was an interpreter. She was divorced and already had three children. They liked her new partner. Eberhard was an agronomist who modernized failing agricultural estates around Berlin.
They got married on April 1st, 1933. It was a lousy date to get married. But of course, they could not know that in advance. They felt they were witnessing a failure of human decency. That's the only way I can explain it. They were both fully aware of what was going on. They had good contacts. They were from very different family backgrounds. My father was from Hamburg, open-minded and cosmopolitan. That is certainly one element. And my mother was anything but narrow-minded. She was appalled by all the Nazi rubbish.
Eberhard Helmrich always looked for ways to protect Jews so they wouldn't be rounded up and murdered. In 1942, he set up the Hiravka labor camp. It was a small farm that grew vegetables for the German soldiers and SS. He employed up to 300 Jews there.
And he decided that he would use Jews from the ghetto of Borislav to work on the farm. But you see, the excuse that he gave to the Gestapo is, the Jews are working for the German army. They are working for, why kill them? I'm a German, I'm in uniform, and I want to help the army, so I'm using these Jews. They are working, and they work good. They would work better than the Ukrainians or the Poles. Why? Because a Jew, even if he's sick, he's going to go to work because he knows his life depends on that. And that's how he kept these Jews alive on the farm, Eberhard, okay?
We called it like a slave labor camp, but it was, you know, and it wasn't. And my parents were chosen to join that with some friends and some relatives. Children weren't allowed, but we were sneaked in. So during the day, my parents would be working in the fields or whatever they were doing, and my sister and I would be in the barracks, usually hidden for a number of hours while they came around to inspect it to make sure there were no kids there. So we would be like in a little cupboard, or we would be put under some bedding, very tiny. And that went on, I guess, for many, many months.
Helmrich bribed SS guards, but he couldn't always prevent raids. 5-year-old Celia was hidden in a hayloft just before soldiers searched the property.
What I saw just out of a corner of the hay is the bayonets going like that, so I jumped up. And one of them actually pulled a pistol on me, didn't shoot me because they were saving bullets, and pushed me towards the window. But anyway, when I was pushed, my uncle, I believe it was my uncle, ran out of the line and caught me. Helmrich sprang into action before the shooting started. Well, they were probably just going to take me and smash me against, you know, a wall. That he needed my father for something or other, and he needed my mother for some special work, and he needed this one for that. And he saw this mess, and he was going to take care of it the best way, personally. And that's how he was saved that day.
That night, Helmrich took Celia and her family to a Polish farmer who hid them.
My father had come up with the idea of providing Jewish Polish girls with false papers and sending them to Berlin. My mother then found work for the girls as maids and nannies. Her acquaintances all knew that her husband was in Poland and had access to workers. And all our German women have to work in the factories, so this looks like a promising alternative. My mother would say, "We'll see what we can do." These families had no idea that these young women looking after their dear children were Jewish, and all those women were saved. I asked my mother what it had been like. "You must have been frightened." And she said, "You can't spend 12 years being frightened." That was her answer. My father said the same thing. He reckoned his chance of survival at 5% and the probability of dying at 95%, given what he was doing in Drohobych. He said, from that moment on, he became totally calm and confident, and he no longer felt any fear.
2 decades later, Donata was honored posthumously. Their daughter Cornelia planted a tree for her on the Avenue of the Righteous.